Despite high expectations, The Acolyte faced intense backlash and criticism from the debut of the first episodes right until the end of the season. These past few weeks, it seemed like the Star Wars fanbase was completely reunited for one reason and one reason only. This show completely ruined Star Wars. How many times I've heard those words these past 2 months? Whether you looked at a review on YouTube, a random post on Reddit, or any comment section on TikTok about The Acolyte, people everywhere couldn't stop talking about how incredibly bad this show was. When I've seen this unfolding for the first time, I've been left purely amazed. Like, sure, I understand not everyone likes the show, and you're entitled to your own opinion, obviously. But the amount of hate this show was getting was just too much. And then I've seen somebody online saying The Acolyte is worse than the Book of Boba Fett. That's when I knew I had to make this video. Of course, even I, the person defending this show, can't say the show is the best piece of Star Wars content we've ever had. The writing at times gets very bad, the total budget of $180 million is just unconceivable considering what we've ended up getting, and all of the episode lengths are just too small. Those are all valid claims, but when you start repeatedly talking about how Star Wars is now woke and gay because of this show, then something's wrong. A lot of people were complaining right from the first episode about how that first Jedi that gets killed by Mei died from a knife stab wound, while Sabine was able to survive a lightsaber stab. Okay, but one was in an area close to the heart, and the other was in the stomach, with the wound already cauterized thanks to the lightsaber. You can see how that would be possible. Others, or the same people for all I know, were complaining about the fact Osha was repairing a fire in space. I've got to admit, that whole scene with the witches of Kofar was a pretty dumb idea, even I can see that, but the amount of backlash the writers got for making Osha and Mei be made with magic or force or whatever that virgins was, it was just too much. That episode was when people started saying, Star Wars is over and it's finished and I can't watch this woke shit anymore. I guess this hate kind of diminished when the latter episodes dropped with a sort of explanation for that, but even so, not many people know this, but there is a canon comic book about Darth Vader in which he finds out he was actually created with Palpatine's help by influencing Shmi's womb or something like that, I don't know exactly the specifics. I am more than sure that if these specific moments didn't exist, people would have found other ways to push their agenda about how bad this show is, and I'll explain why in a minute. Again, I know this show could have been a lot better, but just look at all the cool ideas and concepts the writers have come up with. I've never thought I would see a fight between a possessed Jedi Wookiee and two Jedi. Say what you want about The Acolyte, but you have to admit the lightsaber fights and just combat scenes overall were incredible, especially compared to other media like Ahsoka and even the sequels. And those Plagueis and Yoda cameos, I know that haters were really mad that they've made their appearance. They were saying those moments were just methods for this show to hide its problems and make you believe it's actually good. But remember, this isn't Star Wars. Those two cameos are there just to keep you watching. Yeah. No. If season 2 actually makes its way out there, which I think it will, because apparently it's had pretty good view counts, even with all the hating going on, I think Yoda and Plagueis will have major roles in the next season. Kimir doesn't seem to know that Plagueis is actually there, which could make for an interesting plot point. And Vernestra was asking for Yoda's help, so I think this is only the beginning for them. This first season laid the foundations for what could be a really good second season, but I won't even try and assume such a thing is possible, considering the current state of Star Wars and its fanbase. Am I the only one that thinks this fanbase lately has rather been looking for reasons to hate on new content than to like it? Whether it's the newest season of The Mandalorian, or The Bad Batch, the Ahsoka series, or even Tales of the Empire, there were always reasons to complain. And for these shows, I get it, because there were a lot of valid claims to be had. The fourth season of The Mandalorian was mostly filler, the Ahsoka series had problems with its choreography and writing a little, and the list just goes on. However, for The Acolyte, it seemed like people's minds were already made up months before its release, just because one of the writers was woke? Opinions based not on the trailers we got, but on interviews and things said out of context. That is not the Jedi way. Okay, I'm sorry I said that. It is a lot easier to hate on something with all of your heart, especially when it seems all the others are doing exactly the same. I get it, you don't have to like this show. I am kind of in between, because I liked the lightsaber choreography and Kimir's character in general with his punchy one-liners.
Was that its name?
However, I found the Osha and Mei moments of the story to be kinda boring and slow, and that was my main problem with the story. Apart from that, I didn't find this show worthy to be the end of Star Wars and Disney. The main problem with all of this is there are YouTubers, Star Wars YouTubers in particular, that just love to make this kind of content for clicks and engagement. Let's be serious. Videos where you talk about how incredibly idiotic the Acolyte was or how the writers of this show were, are going to perform incredibly well, because the fans like this sort of content. I don't know how we've gotten to this point, but here we are. Instead of actually trying to make good content that engages viewers, it's a lot easier to make clickbaity videos like Disney cancels The Acolyte because it's so trash, and unfortunately, that isn't going to change anytime soon. This fanbase has always been hating on whatever new content Lucasfilm has been putting out, even before George Lucas sold Star Wars. The most notorious example I can give, the prequels. Those films were hated back then. If you were to somehow travel through time and talk to someone that's just seen The Phantom Menace about how those films are going to be called masterpieces 20 years later by the fanbase, he would probably die from laughter or strangle you. Even Andor, probably the best Star Wars show we've ever got, had problems with the fanbase. Some people were either complaining about how slow this show was, or about the fact bricks and screws were used in the production, and how it completely ruins the immersion. Nevertheless, as I said earlier, I think that enough people have watched this show so far for Disney to decide to make another season, despite the fact it has an average of 17% audience score on Rotten Tomatoes. It's also kind of interesting that this also got an 80% on the critics side of things. It's clear that it got review bombed, and that's why the audience score is under 20%, but it just feels weird for there to be such a discrepancy. What I mean to say in simple English is, how have the critics enjoyed this so much? You'd normally expect them to be the ones complaining and not the fans. Back to my point, I am very worried about the next season of this thing. Most people won't change their opinions as usual, so this next season will 100% be even more garbage than this one. Just because. This is the saddest part in all of this. People aren't going to be willing to give this another chance, just as they weren't before its debut. All most of them did is watch somebody's video on YouTube about how this is going to be woke in advance, and there is no actual reason for The Acolyte to be good. Or just decided to go with the rest of the crowd and hate on it from the beginning. What I tried here is not to prove to you that The Acolyte is actually a masterpiece, but to try to entice you to form your own opinion about what you watch and not listen to what other people say. I don't know if I managed to, but at least I tried to defend this show. Also, I am curious what you think about this subject, so be sure to write your hateful comments about me in the comment section. Now, if you want me to talk about what makes a great Star Wars game, the video is right here, and also like this video and subscribe to my channel if you've enjoyed this video. Bye!